Hello friends, so today we will study the topic called chemical thermodynamics. So chemical thermodynamics, its literal meaning is we see that there are two terms, one is thermo, one is dynamics. So thermo means actually heat. Thermo means, it is a Greek word, it means heat, and dynamic means flow or movement. So what is you can derive from this word, thermo means flow of heat. So we say flow of heat. And this subject is called as the study of heat flow. A study of flow of heat or heat flow. How heat can be flowing. So let's take one example, cooling of hot tea. You take one tea, it is in a cup and put in the room temperature. So in that room temperature, what will happen? The tea will automatically become cool. This is very clear. The tea will become automatically cool. Why it is becoming cool? Because this hot energy, it will goes into the surrounding, so automatically tea becomes cool. Okay, means the heat is flowing from the tea to the surrounding, because the surrounding temperature is less and the temperature of tea in the cup is high. So definitely the flow of heat from the cup of tea to the surrounding. So this is just like the exothermic phenomenon is going on. Take one more example, like a melting of ice. So if you take this ice and put in room temperature, what will happen? The ice will melt down. Why it is melting? Because this is absorbing heat from the surrounding to this ice. So when this heat is taking from the surrounding, so it is absorbing. So in this case, heat is coming out. In this case, heat is absorbing. So likewise, we have so many examples in which there is the heat is absorbing, heat is releasing. So both exothermic and endothermic phenomena is going on. So we will study in these topics. So since this term is used in wider sense, so it has a very wide value, wide sense. So it is dealt with all forms of energy. We are dealing here two energies, it can be dealt any form of energy. So this field is concerned with a study of all energy relations, energy transformations, and most commonly heat into work or vice versa. So we will study heat into work is most commonly used, that is in our special course, or work into heat. Okay. So it may be defined as the branch of science which deals with the quantitative relationships between heat and all forms of energy. So it is a quantitative relationship in terms of quantity, how much quantity between heat and other forms of energy has been taken place. We'll deal these type of topics. Physical and chemical processes are accompanied by energy changes. So physical and chemical process, when energy change take place, physical process, it may happen in physical process and it can also happen in chemical process, both phenomena. Since the cooling of hot tea, melting of ice, all these are the physical process. So in chemical process means chemical reactions are there. So but we confine our study to two thermodynamics of chemical process. So we'll study only chemical process, not physical process. So it is referred to as chemical thermodynamics. That's why our topic is chemical thermodynamics. So chemical thermodynamics is the branch of thermodynamics which deals with the study of the process in which chemical energy is involved. So our topic is only chemical thermodynamics, not any other thermodynamics. We are not going to study any other branches. The strength of the thermodynamics. The strength of thermodynamics, it lies in the fact that this subject provides theoretical description of observations gained by human in a long period of time. So human is observing this phenomena for a long time. So thermodynamics, these laws are not derived. It's not derived. It is generalized by human experience. So by human experience, we are generalizing some laws. This generalization of laws are called as first, second and third law of thermodynamics. And the prediction based on these laws, prediction based upon these laws, it has been verified. These laws also have been verified in most of the cases. So far, no case has been reported where these laws break down. So since we have seen that no law has been breakdown, all laws are fully valid. So what does first law deals? The first law that deals with the equivalence of different forms of energy. And second law deals with the direction of chemical change. And third law has to evaluate the thermodynamic parameters like entropy. So we'll study these laws in details in the coming topics. So now we study the branches. Branches means we have two branches. One is called classical thermodynamics and another is called statistical thermodynamics. So in classical thermodynamics, it is mainly concerned with the properties of matter in bulk. Bulk means macroscopic properties. So but not related to the models of the internal constituent of matter, that is atoms, ions and molecules. We study only bulk properties, classical thermodynamics. In statistics, it involves the definitely connecting the thermodynamic property at the atomic and bulk level. It is taking both atomic as well as bulk level, but we are in concern with the only bulk matter in our course. So it has some objectives and limitations of thermodynamics. So what are the objective limitations? So objective means it to predict the feasibility of a process, whether the process is feasible or not. It will predict process means can be physical also, it can be chemical also. So whether or not a process will occur under the given set of conditions, so can be predicted by applying the principle of thermodynamics. So from this principle, we can say the process feasible or not. Second, to estimate the yield of the product. It also tells the yield of the product. So the thermodynamic relations, it helps to predict the yield of the product obtainable in a process or in a reaction. So it is possible to know the extent up to which the reaction takes place before attaining equilibrium. Third, to deduce some important relationship in physical chemistry. So from this we can deduce some relationship. For example, useful results like Rod's law, lowering of vapor pressure, expression for depression in freezing point, elevation in boiling point, distribution law, phase rule, law of mass action, etc. These can be derived by the laws of thermodynamics. It provides the systematic order to present the experimental data. So it also gives the systematic order to present the experimental data. So all these are very important objectives for the thermodynamics. Now what are the limitations? Limitation means it deals the properties like temperature, pressure, etc. of the matter in bulk. So in bulk it is dealing these things with macroscopic quantities, but not with the microscopic quantities. So in this topic we are not it is not dealing with the microscopic quantity, because these are present in very less amounts. So we always study the macroscopic quantities. In other words, it deals with the large group of atoms, molecules, ions, rather than individual atoms and molecules. We are not going to study the energy change of atoms, molecules or ions. We will study the bulk. We can't take one as a single atom. We will take the groups or bulk atoms. This is the one big limitation in the thermodynamics. It helps to predict the feasibility of a process, but does not tell anything about the time taken for the process. It is not telling about the time taken process to complete or the rate at which the process would proceed. For example, this is like this is the ethylene. So in ethylene, what happens? It is giving you carbon plus hydrogen. So this reaction is required, is feasible thermodynamic. The reaction is feasible thermodynamic. But the C2H2 is stable for a long period. Similarly, H2 plus O2 will give you water. But if you take the mixture of two, this is gases, hydrogen plus oxygen, it can be kept for a long time without any chemical change. So it does not tell about the time. It's not telling the time is taking fast, by the time is taking slow. So it does not tell anything about the feasibility process, but it will tell the feasibility, but does not tell anything about the time taken for the process to complete or the rate. So rate also does not tell. So time or rate it is not predicting. Third point, it concerns itself only with the initial and final states of a system and not concerned with the path by which the change is brought about. So path is not discussing, it is concerning only the initial how much was the energy and final how much was the energy. So it will change the energy change of the initial and final states of the system. So that is, it does not explain the mechanism of a process. Fourth point, so thermodynamic laws do not explain the departure of the system from equilibrium state. So from equilibrium state also, how much departure has taken place, the system is taking place in the departure. It also is not explaining. Now we'll see some terminology, general terminology. So This terminology is number A, system, surrounding and the boundaries. What are the terminology? System. System, or we can say thermodynamic system. We can say in both ways. The part of the universe chosen for thermodynamic consideration. The part of the universe chosen for thermodynamic consideration. That is to study the effect of normally pressure, volume or temperature, etc. is called thermodynamic system or system. Because this part can be regulated or it can be controlled. This part of this system can be regulated or controlled. That's why it is called as the system or thermodynamic system. If it concerned with the energy changes. The remaining portion of the universe, means this is the part of the universe, means other part of the universe or remaining portion of the universe excluding the system is called like the surrounding. This means that, means whole universe is made up of two parts. Everything, that is everything outside the system, can have a direct effect on that system. Means this is the system and the other part is called surrounding. Means universe is made up of two parts. One is called system, other is called surrounding. Means system can affect surrounding, surrounding can affect system. So interaction takes place. So on the basis of interaction, so there are with the surroundings, there are three type of system. On the basis of interaction, there are three type of system. These systems are open system, closed system and isolated system. And how their interaction takes place? Interaction takes place in terms of exchange of matter and energy with the surrounding and its wall. Exchange of matter energy with the surrounding and wall is permeable. In case of open, if it is energy in matter is permeable, means transfer in matter both will take place, that is called open system. Means matter is transferring and energy also transfer. For example, if you take the cup of hot tea, say from that tea, some energy is transferring to, or this tea is converting to vapor form. The tea is converting to vapor form and it is going to the surrounding. Simultaneously, energy is also going to the surrounding because this is the hot and surrounding is cool. So energy is transferring from hot to cool, and again the tea is converting to vapor form. It is also surrounding from the, it is also leaving the tea, a cup of tea, and going to the surrounding. So in this way, matter plus energy, both is surrounding. Similarly, cell. In cell, what happens? Wall is permeable. Here, wall is permeable. In this case, boundary is imaginary. So it is easily passed. In this case, cell waste materials, nutrients also is permeable to from its wall. That's why biological cell, a cup of hot tea, this is the open system. Closed system, matter is not transferred, only energy is transferred. Matter is not transferred, energy is transferred. Means if you take the stoppered flask with the diathermic bond. Diathermic bond means the boundary in which the energy can be transferred. Isolated, neither matter nor energy, both are not transferred. So example is your sealed flask that is thermally or mechanically or electrically insulated from its surrounding. So I have drawn here diagram, you can see this cup of tea. So if you can hear in this diagram, you can see the matter as well as energy both is transferring. This is closed system, it is covered, it is closed by the piston. So in this case, gas is present. So what will happen? So if this is gas is hot, so energy can be transferred from hot to outside. So it can goes from this to this. Okay. So from interaction take place through the wall. This wall is diathermic. This wall is diathermic, conducting walls. And this is the your sealed flask. This is flask is totally sealed. So in this case, what happens? This content presents some matter. So this matter is not transferring some energy or matter. Nothing is transferred because this wall is isolated, totally sealed from the top side and from the wall side. So this is called as the isolated system. On the basis of composition, system is two types. One is the homogeneous system, second is the heterogeneous system. So in under the homogeneous system, in this what happens, each intensive macroscopic property is constant throughout the system. So you have to pay attention, intensive macroscopic properties. And if system is not homogeneous, then it consists of a number of homogeneous parts. So in that homogeneous system, many parts are there, so that parts are homogeneous. And this homogeneous part of a system is called as a phase. This means that we see example is mixture of gases. So all mixture of gases means all small components are, so it has only one phase, but all small components are homogeneous uniformly distributed. Similarly, true solutions. So this is also example of homogeneous system. If the system consists of a crystal of silver bromide in equilibrium with the aqueous solution silver bromide, like this one. Silver bromide is present in solid state and silver bromide is present in aqueous state. So there are two different phases of the system, phases of the homogeneous present in the one phase, that is aqueous solution. So it has two phase and that phase is homogeneous, but it consists of two different phase, that is a homogeneous part. One is the solid state, homogeneous, uniformly distributed, and second the aqueous solution. This also called as the homogeneous system. So note that, so one important point, just note it. What is the meaning of phase? So in this, here we are discussing phase. Phase does not mean that solid, liquid or gases completely. So a system can be entirely liquid or solid. Can be entirely liquid or is consist of solid or liquid. And still have more than one phase. So a system consisting water in liquid state and CCl4 in carbon tetrachloride in liquids. So this is a whole liquid, but it consists of two phases, water and CCl4. This is called as the homogeneous system. Now heterogeneous system. So a system consists of two or more phases is heterogeneous. A system consists of two or more phases. So here examples are ice in contact with water. So one is ice, one is water. So both are not uniformly distributed. So this system is called as the heterogeneous. Or two or more immiscible liquids like oil with two different oil like kerosene and petrol. You can see kerosene and water like this one. And insoluble solid in contact with the liquid. A chalk with water. So this is totally called heterogeneous system. Now second topic, that is surrounding. So rest part of the universe excluding the system is called surrounding, that we discussed earlier, but can interact with the system or influence the properties of the system. We suppose this is the cup of the tea which consists of hot milk. So this hot milk, it is the energy of the hot milk or matter of the hot milk is going to the surrounding. So this whole part of the system, but the energy, the matter which is due to hot, it is going to surrounding. That is called surrounding, the rest part of the universe. It can be nearby or it can be any part. That is called surrounding. Boundary. So boundary can be real or imaginary between the system or surrounding. So between the system, suppose a cup of hot tea is the system, and this the outer part, the cup part, this part is called as the boundary. So this part is the real boundary, but this is open system. So this is in this matter energy can be exchanged with the surrounding. So this can be exchanged with surrounding. Okay, so this boundary is called as the imaginary boundary. A boundary can be rigid. So this whole part is the rigid body because it's solid. So its position and shapes are definite. And non-rigid means it can be movable or it can be permeable. Means the wall can be permeable or wall can be impermeable. Like permeable means like cell. So it does not permit the passage of matter. A boundary can be adiabatic or diathermic. So adiabatic means its wall is rigid, and diathermic is wall is also rigid. But in case of a diathermic wall, they permit energy but not matter. Okay, like this one. So if cup of tea, if you touch this cup of tea, what will happen? You will feel the hotness. So if you feel the hotness, this means this the heat is conducting through the clay part of the wall. Okay, so this wall is diathermic. So the wall can be rigid but adiabatic. Adiabatic means they do not permit the energy as well as matter. I mean, exchange of heat is not possible through this. So this is possible in the thermoflask, where the wall is what is that? It is adiabatic. State of a system or thermodynamic state. So after the system surroundings and body, so next is the state of a system. So it implies a conditions. It implies a condition of the system. It is a condition when the various macroscopic properties like pressure, volume, temperature, etc. of the system have a definite value. So they have a definite value. And the first and last state of the system is called the initial and final state respectively. So in this system, if you are taking the first state, that is called the initial state. If you take the last state of the system, that is called final state of the system respectively. And such a property which defines a particular state of a system are known as state function. So that system which has a particular state is called state function. So in a particular thermodynamic state, these properties, that is pressure, volume, temperature, etc. properties, they are equilibrium with each other and they do not vary with time. Means they become constant. And such a state of the system is called a state of thermodynamic equilibrium. So one concept, one more term is that thermodynamic equilibrium, in which the pressure, volume and temperature, etc., these macroscopic properties not vary with time.